French show. Mon Dieu, I'm the Stephen L. Show. We're in Montreal. That was the St. Lawrence River. And oh, I'm a star up here. What can I tell you? The French just love me. The Montreal. I'm here. This is the 10th year. And look, I'm actually, oops, excuse me. I'm just so relaxed and happy to be here in Montreal at the Montreal World Film Festival. We're going to be here for the next few weeks. And it's just, you wouldn't believe who's up here. Tony Curtis. I mean, hello. Tony Curtis on the Stephen Holt Show. So, Marcia Gay Harden and so many fabulous French and international stars are coming up. I can't even begin to list them all. But it's the city of Montreal is the star. Le Festival des Films du Montréal. Du Monde, pardonnez-moi, Du Monde, le Festival des Films du Monde est ici, et commence, it's just too fabulous for words, and Peter Rayner, our friend from the film critic from the Christian Science Monitor is going to be here, and Peter and I came in on the same plane yesterday, and we had this grand tour of an area I'd never seen before. I wish we'd had a camera with us, called Lachine, which is all along the St. Lawrence River, all these beautiful homes. Oh, my God, I wanted to move here immediately. Of course, I felt that way out in Woodside at the Marjolin Patisserie. I wanted to move to Mood. I guess I'm just, you know, open to suggestion at this point. So we're going to, and Vicky Cristina Barcelona, that film is here. The stars aren't, but the film is here. Just opening now, and I am so happy to be here, and I'm so happy to be with you, and mwah! Je t'aime le monde, je t'aime la vie, aujourd'hui à le Festival des Films du Mont en Montréal, encore une fois, fantastique!
Meow! Encore une fois, bonjour! We are now in the Place des Jardins, and we are about to experience a press conference, or a petit pas of a press conference, with Tony Curtis on the Stephen Holt Show. Who thought? Who would have thunk? I mean, Tony Curtis, Stephen Holt, he's here with his wife, his current wife, and the movie is called The Jill and Tony Curtis Story. So, ne bougez pas. Oh.
This way. Come on.
Marilyn and I were old friends. We met when we first started in movies, 1948, 1949. I was 23, she was 20. And we met at the studio. And we became friends. And we were together for about, 6-7 months. We both learned about each other and about man and woman by being with each other. Then my career started to move, and she almost started, then she started. When both of us were working in films, we would run across each other occasionally. We had a wonderful time when we were together. She was learning about what it was like to be an actress. She had difficulty playing parts. She could only bring herself to the part. And so that delayed her. Then things were really going well for her. We met when we made Some Like It Hot. By the time we did Some Like It Hot, Marilyn was having trouble in the business. Difficult trouble, as all young starlets did. And from then on in, one amounted to another. And I wasn't with her anywhere near her when she died, but I loved her. She was a beautiful woman, easily attracted to situations and people she shouldn't have been with. Thank you. Next. Murder. It's not true. Marilyn was in a very difficult position just before she died. She had no control, and she did herself in. God bless you, Marilyn. Four favorite films.
Please.
The Boston Strangler was a film that I enjoyed a lot. It put my mind, as we spoke a minute ago, it put my mind in another place. As I said the dialogue, I knew I was hiding something. It was a wonderful experience. And there it was, I had a different nose, brown contact lens, put on some weight. So there was someone else doing the part. Some Like It Hot. Some Like It Hot is an outstanding comedy. And I always hoped that I would end up in comedies and movies. I always admired Cary Grant and all the actors that were funny, that were able to portray funny. And Cary Grant was one of them.